Mini Maisie's Journal. All wrapped up. Dayna and Maisie wake up early. They're what you call early birds. A clear sky outside the window, so great they can't put it to words. A sunny sky is a clear sign of an amazing day. Dayna jumps from out her bed at 7:30 without delay. Dayna starts every day with her mug and the click of a kettle, ready to fill her days and be busy, but sometimes she's forgetful. She plans all of her days in advance, but little things fall through the cracks. But there's something big she's forgotten. It stops her still in her tracks. Maisie points to something. Tomorrow is a special date. It's her best friend Susie's birthday. Of this month, it's the 8th. She remembered to buy her presents. A necklace and chocolates large in size. But she hasn't got any wrapping paper or a card to keep her gifts a surprise. That wasn't on the schedule, Dayna thought. I haven't got any time. By the time she'd finished breakfast, it was already 8:55. She'd already done this week's shopping, and there was no time to go out again. Now she'd spent too much time worrying. It was almost 9:45. And so she started to panic. Her day was filled with things to do. With painting lots of pictures. And playing with Maisie too. But now she had to find paper to wrap up both her gifts. Dayna asked Maisie for ideas to help her with her list. Maisie wondered if Dayna didn't mind changing some of her plans and combining some together. Maisie could even lend a hand. Maisie thought rather than buying paper, that's completely brand new, why doesn't Dayna paint her own? Recycle what she's already used. Dayna thought this idea was brilliant. She could do two things at once. She'd even be saving the environment, and it would be at no extra cost. Because when you recycle, there's no need to buy again. And the more things that you use, the less you put in the bin. Maisie helped look through the recycling, with no time left to lose. She found an old box of tea bags and all of yesterday's news, while Dayna looked through her supplies to find the best paint and felt tips. And a quick look in the garden provided some leaves, a pine cone and a twig, with all the supplies on the craft table. Dayna began to think, what colour should I paint the newspaper? Maisie thinks it should be pink. So, with a large paintbrush, a pink layer she applied. Once finished, she left it on her windowsill, waiting for it to dry. While the paint was drying, they could both have a cup of tea. They played games and told stories, and even hide and seek. But after a while, they could continue with the next step in the process. With white paint, Dayna painted on some leaves. And on the paper, Maisie pressed. Now with all of Dayna's bright colours, she used a large pine cone to make some unique markings, designs to call her own. The girls waited again for drying, but it didn't take too long. There wasn't even time to sing all their favourite Taylor Swift songs. Now that the paint wasn't wet anymore, there was one more touch to add. Dayna made lots of squiggles and shapes. The fun designs made her glad. She had finished wrapping the present. Only the card was left to construct. She found some paper and she wrote, Happy Birthday, Susie, on the front. Dayna wrote her name at the bottom. Maisie tried to do a scribble as well. Now, they just had to wait till tomorrow, until they could ring Susie's doorbell. And so, when the next day came, Dayna and Maisie bolted out the door. They kept their distance as they left the present on Susie's porch. Although they couldn't play with their friend, it was nice they were still keeping in touch. Susie enjoyed her presents and sent a letter to thank them so much. Maisie had so much fun with Dayna. They painted and they played. And Dayna was even planning in advance to do it again another day. Join Maisie on 3 online adventures, published every Sunday. We hope to see you there. Bye-bye.